हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज पार्ट टू ऑफ लाइफ प्रोसेसेस चैप्टर सिक्स ऑफ क्लास टेंथ. इन पार्ट वन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट आर लाइफ प्रोसेसेस, व्हाट इज द मेजर क्राइटेरियन फॉर डिसाइडिंग वेदर समथिंग इज लिविंग और नॉन लिविंग. एंड इन दैट वी डिस्कस्ड द वन ऑफ द लाइफ प्रोसेस दैट इज न्यूट्रिशन. And under nutrition, I just gave hints about autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So in this part 2, we'll discuss about the autotrophic mode of nutrition, that is nutrition by plants, in details, and some experimental proofs related to the autotrophic mode of nutrition or the photosynthesis in case of plants. Okay, so let me start with the mode of nutrition, that is here I am going to discuss autotrophic mode of nutrition, and in other part I will discuss heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So what is autotrophic mode of nutrition? What do you mean by autotroph? Auto means self, trophy means nutrition. So it is the mode of nutrition where the organism does not depend on other living beings for food, rather they can synthesize or make their own food by a process called photosynthesis. Okay, so since they are self-dependent, that means they are self-sufficient and they can synthesize their own foods, so they are called autotrophs. Who are the autotrophs? The autotrophs are the green plants and the autotrophic bacteria like blue-green algae and algae, simply green algae. Now, when we are talking about the autotrophic mode of nutrition, it is the nutrition in plants, that is green plants. And the green plants prepare their food, as I said, by the process of photosynthesis. Okay, then what is photosynthesis? It is the synthesis of food in presence of light. But is only light is sufficient for synthesis of food? No, absolutely not. But light is very much essential for the synthesis of food. But besides that, the other components required for the photosynthesis are carbon dioxide and water. Okay, so now what are the conditions or the factors required for photosynthesis? As I said, that is, the name itself indicates, photo means light, synthesis means preparation or making, so making the food in presence of light. So obviously sunlight is one of the most important factor necessary for photosynthesis. Then the next is your chlorophyll. Chlorophyll are the green pigments present in the plant cell. Okay, in the chloroplast of plant cell. The next is your carbon dioxide, that is present in the atmosphere. The plant receives it from the atmosphere. Then water. The water is received by the plants from the soil through its root. Now we can see the common equation, general equation for photosynthesis. Here carbon dioxide, CO2 plus H2O, H2O is water, in presence of sunlight, the chlorophyll pigment can convert carbon dioxide and water into carbohydrate or glucose, C6H12O6. It is the formula for glucose. Glucose is a simplest form of carbohydrate, and then oxygen is released. So what is important? What is the input? What are the raw materials? The raw materials are your carbon dioxide and water and sunlight. And what are the output? The output is the food or carbohydrate or the glucose and oxygen. Okay, So this is the process, just reverse of respiration. In respiration, we take carbon dioxide, or the plant take oxygen and releases carbon dioxide. But in photosynthesis, it is just reverse. The plant takes carbon dioxide and releases oxygen. So that's why the content of carbon dioxide and oxygen in the atmosphere is in balanced condition. So here you can see the process of photosynthesis. Here is the green plant, and that green plant is having green leaves. The leaves have the green pigments, that is chlorophyll pigments. The chlorophyll pigment receives, that plant receives the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and light energy from the sun, and then water from the soil, and it prepares the food in the leaf. Then from the leaf, the food is transported to different parts of the plant. Now what is released? Oxygen is released, and food is prepared, and that is utilized by the plant for various purposes. Now, what events are occurring during the photosynthesis? So during photosynthesis, the three most important events are occurring. The first one is your absorption of light energy by chlorophyll. As I was saying you, that the chlorophyll pigments are present in the leaves or the green parts of the plant, they absorb the sunlight. So light is the form of energy, so they absorb the light energy. Then the second step is that these chlorophyll pigments convert the light energy to chemical energy. So what is chemical energy? The chemical energy is the carbohydrate or the glucose, because this is the chemical compound. Okay, and what else is taking place? The water that is the plant is getting through the root is splitted off into hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, this splitting off of water takes place in presence of light, and that process is called photolysis of water. So what is the second event? The light energy is converted into chemical energy, that is carbohydrate, and the water in presence of light is splitted off into hydrogen and oxygen. So oxygen is released into the atmosphere. Then third step is the reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrate. So the carbon dioxide is taken by the plant from the atmosphere. Then what happens to that carbon dioxide? The energy that is produced during the second step is now utilized for reduction of carbon dioxide and convert it into carbohydrate. Okay, so these steps are taking place one after the other immediately. Okay, there is no gap between these three steps. So one after another, very soon the process, one process is followed by the another process. Then now, how the plant obtain the carbon dioxide? The plant has a stomata, okay. So you are very much aware of this stomatal structure. In class 9th as well as 8th, you have studied about the structure of stomata. So these are the structure of stomata. On the left side, the stomata is open, and on the left right side, the stomata is closed. So in the stomata, you can see that there are two yellow color bean shaped structures are there. They are known as guard cells. So there are two guard cells which enclose an opening that is known as stomatal opening, okay, or stomatal pore. Now these guard cells are surrounded by some other cells, green color cells. They are known as subsidiary cells. That means peripheral cells. Okay. And besides that, you can see that in the guard cell, that is yellow color cell, some green patches are there. These green patches are the chloroplast. Okay. So when this stomata opens, the carbon dioxide enters into it. Okay. So this is the opening through which the exchange of gas, that is taking of gas, intake of carbon dioxide and exit of oxygen takes place. So the plant receives the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere through the stomata. So on the right side, the stomata is closed. So there are certain conditions which are very, very essential for the opening of the stomata and closing of the stomata. Okay. For example, temperature, light intensity, then day and night, then your moisture content. So these are all responsible for opening and closing of the stomata. Okay. So this is how the plant gets carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Then now, how the plant obtain water from the water for photosynthesis? It's very much clear that the plant takes the water from the soil through its root. Okay. And in the root, you have studied in class 9th about the tissues. And one complex tissue is there, that is known as xylem. So the xylem elements are having that is vessels. So vessels are tubular structures, elongated tubular structures. So in the root, these tubular structures are arranged one above the another, and even stem also, in the stem also they are arranged like this, and they form a continuous column, and through which the absorbed water is carried up to the topmost part of the plant, and so also to the leaves for the purpose of photosynthesis. And along with water, the minerals are also carried to the leaves, which are required for the process of photosynthesis. Okay. So these minerals are not only essential for the process of photosynthesis, they are also essential for the other functions of activities of the plant, like nitrogen that is obtained from the soil is essential for the for making the proteins and the other compounds. Okay. So this is how the plant obtain water from the soil for photosynthesis. Now, site of photosynthesis. Now, the plant has many parts. Which is the actual site where the photosynthesis occurs? The photosynthesis takes place in the photosynthetic cells present in the leaves or the green parts of the plant. And those cells which can carry out photosynthesis are containing the chloroplast or the chlorophyll pigments, and such cells are known as mesophyll cells. Okay. And these mesophyll cells contain more amount of chlorophyll pigments as compared to other parts of the plant, like the stem. Young stems are also looking green, so they also contain the green pigment, but as compared to leaves, they contain less number of less chlorophyll pigments. So here I am showing you the exact site where the photosynthesis is taking place. So this is the section of a leaf. This is the cross section of a leaf. Here you can see that is in the leaf the vein is there. So through the vein the water is carried up to the tip of the leaf, and the veinlets are there. There is a midrib, and the veinlets are there. So through this the water is supplied to the leaf lamina, and from the stem the water comes to the leaf through the xylem element that is present in the midrib of the leaf. So here it is labeled as your xylem and phloem in the vascular bundle. So, and you already know what are vascular bundles. You have already studied it in class 9. Okay. Now see the section of the below structure is the section of the leaves, and here you can see the upper epidermis and the lower epidermis. The upper row of cell is called the upper epidermis. Okay, and these epidermal cells are covered by a waxy layer that is known as cuticle. So what is the role of cuticle? See, if cuticle will not be there, the waxy layer will not be there, then the excess amount of water will be lost from the leaf due to transpiration. So this cuticle prevents the excess loss of water due to transpiration. Then come to the below that epidermal cell, some elongated cells are there, vertical cells are there, vertical rows of cells are there, that is pillar like cells. They are known as the mesophyll cells, and below these cells, elongated cells, some others different shaped cells are there. They are also the mesophyll cells, and you can see that these mesophyll cells are having round structures, small spherical structures, green in color. They are the chloroplast. And in the lower epidermis you can observe there is one opening that is called the stomatal opening. So this is the structure of a leaf, cross section of a leaf, where the mesophyll cells are present, and these mesophyll cells contain the chloroplast, and the photosynthesis takes place in the chloroplast. Now next come to your here, there are certain experimental proofs to experiment evidences that during photosynthesis sunlight is used, or sunlight is essential for this process. So I will explain this experiment here from the diagram, and the points, the procedure, observation and conclusion are given in the slide, but from the diagram I will explain you. Okay, so here in the first diagram, a potted plant with one leaf partly covered with aluminium foil. Okay, you can see one leaf, the in the potted plant, the left right side leaf, some portion of that leaf is covered by aluminium foil. Okay, so what is the purpose of wrapping this portion by aluminium foil? Because when you keep this potted plant under sun, that the portion that is covered by aluminium foil will not get the sunlight. Okay, so now in the other part of the leaf is exposed to the sunlight. Now take out that leaf. In the second diagram you can see that here that leaf is taken in a beaker, or you can say you can take in a test tube even, and put that leaf, then dip that beaker in another beaker, or you can keep it in a water bath where hot water is there. Okay, so now you have taken in the small beaker, we have taken alcohol. Okay, and we have taken water in the water bath. So when water gets boiled, that alcohol also get heated off, and by heating in the alcohol, the chlorophyll pigments are dissolved in the alcohol. That means from the leaf the chlorophyll pigments are removed. Okay, by boiling in the alcohol. Is it clear? Now, in the diagram that is C, diagram C, you can see the color of the leaf. It is almost colorless because the chlorophyll pigments are removed from this. So it is decolorized leaf. It is kept in a petri dish. Now is the most important part. Here we have to know whether the photosynthesis has been taken place or not. If taken place, then in which part of the leaf? Whether in the covered part or in the exposed part. So here in the fourth diagram, that is D, here iodine is added to the leaf. We are adding the iodine with the help of a dropper. So what is observed in the fourth diagram, you can see, we can notice that the part of the leaf that was covered by aluminium foil was not exposed to sunlight, so there is no starch. That means no carbohydrate is prepared or photosynthesis has not been taken place, because starch is a type of carbohydrate. So the starch is not produced as a result of photosynthesis. That means photosynthesis is jagah par hua hi nahi hai. But aap uske dono taraf dekhiye, jo ki aapka sunlight ko expose hua tha, that has become black, blue black in color. Because we know that when iodine is added to starch, the iodine is brown in color. But starch, when it is added to starch, the starch turns into blue black. So from this it is very much clear that sunlight is very very essential for photosynthesis. Since the part is the small part is covered by the aluminium foil that is deprived of the sunlight, so it cannot carry out photosynthesis. So from this it is, what is the conclusion? From this we got the conclusion that light is essential, sunlight is essential for photosynthesis. So here I have given you the observation and conclusion which I have already described you with the help of diagram. So whenever you get time, you can go through these points, the methods as well as the observation and the conclusion, because from this portion you may get questions, okay, that is activity based question may come in the exam. So that's why you should be thorough about the experiments that are given in the textbook. Okay, now next is the experiment to show the necessity of chlorophyll for photosynthesis. So you have studied that carbon dioxide is required, sunlight is required and chlorophyll is required. So here we are proving one by one. How sunlight is required, that we have already proved. Now we have to prove whether chlorophyll is required or not. Okay. So what we have to do here, we have to take a potted plant with variegated leaves. Variegated leaf means you might have seen some crotal leaves which is having patches, that is patches of different color. Some portion are green, some portions are yellow, some portion red, brown, like this. So such leaves are known as variegated leaves. Okay, so that means some part are having chlorophyll and some other parts are not having chlorophyll. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to keep this plant under sun for a few hours, then we have to go for iodine test. Okay, so here with the help of diagram I will show you. Okay, so here you can see on the left side there is a variegated leaf. That means the some portion of the leaf is green in color and some portion is colorless, or some other color may be there. That is due to absence of the chlorophyll pigments. Okay, that is the yellow area. So when starch test is done, starch test means what? When this potted plant with variegated leaf is kept under sunlight, then definitely photosynthesis will take place. But here we have to know in which part of the leaf the photosynthesis is taking place, whether it is taking place in the green part or in the yellow part. Okay, if it is taking place in the green part, then it will be confirmed that the photosynthesis requires the chlorophyll pigments. If it is taking place in the yellow part, then it will be proved that no green pigments or chlorophyll are required for the photosynthesis. So, wherever photosynthesis is taking place, starch is prepared. Starch is a carbohydrate that we have already studied in our, that is, previous slide. We have seen that what is the product? Product is the carbohydrate. The carbohydrate may be a glucose or starch. So now, after keeping it under sunlight, then we went for starch test. That means we have added the iodine solution to the leaf. Then what has happened? On the right side, you can see that the green part of the leaf has been converted into blue black color, but the yellow part has remained as it is. What does it mean? That means the green part has synthesized the starch. The starch is present and the starch is the product of photosynthesis. But in the yellow part, there is no starch, so there is no photosynthesis. So from this, it is very much clear and it is evident that chlorophyll pigments are required for photosynthesis. Then one more experiment we'll discuss that to show the necessity of carbon dioxide, it is another raw material required for photosynthesis. So here what we have to do, here I have given you the procedure, how to conduct the experiment, then what are the observation, then what conclusion we are getting. So here what we have to do, we have to take two plant and we have to take two potted plants, and these potted plants are kept should be kept in two bell jars. I'll show you what are bell jars, and in one of the bell jar the potassium hydroxide solution should be kept, and in the other bell jar there should not be any potassium hydroxide solution. Then they will be kept under sunlight. But let me tell you, before, I mean, keeping them in the bell jar, the plant should be destarched. Then how to make them destarch? Destarch means you keep the both the potted plants in a dark room for few days, 3 or 4 days. So due to lack of sunlight or any light, there will be no photosynthesis in any leaf, any of the leaves of the plants. So in this way, the plant is destarched. No starch is synthesized. Now take out those two potted plants from the dark room. Then keep them inside the bell jar. It is a bell-shaped jar. You can see the bell-shaped jar, and this inside the bell-shaped jar, one of the bell-shaped jar on the left side, we have kept a potassium hydroxide in a petri dish. But on the right side, inside the bell jar, we have not kept anything. Now what happens? What we need to prove? We have to prove that carbon dioxide is required for photosynthesis. So here you can see that in the diagram A, the role of potassium hydroxide is to absorb the carbon dioxide. So whatever carbon dioxide is present inside the bell jar or the carbon dioxide released during the respiration of plant are absorbed by the potassium hydroxide in the setup A. But in the setup B, bell jar B, so carbon dioxide is available. So carbon dioxide is taken up by the plant for and that will be utilized for photosynthesis, and oxygen will be released. and again oxygen will be taken during respiration. So you keep these two plants for 3 to 4 days under sunlight. Then what you will observe? So see what is our observation. You will see that the leaf of the plant with potassium hydroxide solution does not turn to blue black when it is tested for presence of starch. So what has been happened, the jar where the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the potassium hydroxide, the leaves do not have starch. So when iodine is put on those leaves, they are not turned into blue black. That means no photosynthesis has been taken place. And this proves that due to absence of carbon dioxide, the photosynthesis could not take place. But you can ask that why not it is other factors. You can ask it why not it is sunlight. Because we have kept them inside a bell jar. So the sunlight can reach the plant through the, it is a glass jar, through the glass. So there is no lack of sunlight. So sunlight was there. And potted plant, we have given sufficient water. So water is also there. So what is lacking only? Only lacking is your carbon dioxide in the first case. But in the second case, when you take the leaf and you test it for starch by adding iodine, you will see that the leaves has been converted into, the color of the leaf becomes blue and black. That means starch has been synthesized, and this proves that photosynthesis has been taken place. So why this photosynthesis took place? Because sunlight was there, then water was there from the soil, and carbon dioxide was also there, because the carbon dioxide is released during respiration of the plant, and that carbon dioxide is used up during photosynthesis. Okay, so these are the three experiments from which we could prove that the three raw materials are very, very essential for the process of photosynthesis. They are your sunlight, next is your carbon dioxide, and what else? Your chlorophyll pigment. So these activities and the experiments, you have to go through the procedures, then observations, and then the conclusions. Because from this activity part, definitely some question will come in your board exam. So please see this video seriously, and go through each and every point or the notes, whatever is given here, for your reference. And if you have any queries, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you.